Hi, this is Bridget with Life on Spectrum, and today's topic is about menstruation. Now, some of you out there are like, oh, this just is an uncomfortable, topic to talk about with my son or daughter. However, I think it's very important that you do. More and more girls are actually getting menstruation earlier, and there are some students that are actually getting it as age 10 or 11. So it's better to start preparing them for this coming of age, I guess you would say, than to just let them figure it out on their own. Boys also need to know about it because it does affect them in many ways. And so we're going to start this topic by me saying this. Number one, be honest and be blunt. And be very careful about making analogies towards, making references or analogies towards an animal or other thing. Make sure that they actually understand the parts of the woman's body, especially the uterus and the fallopian tubes, and actually talk about eggs. And it's kind of, you can relate them to quote unquote chicken eggs, because chicken eggs won't become a baby chick unless they're fertile. So that is kind of similar. So just be careful though on other analogies unless they make sense and they're actually literal. The other thing I wanted to stress to you too is, when I actually discussed this with my son, he was actually kind of embarrassed, but I told him, I said, without menstruation, you wouldn't have been born. And that's kind of how he started thinking about it, like, wow, you're right, Mom, without it, I wouldn't be here. So it is important for me to know. I also actually taught him that it's important for all men and women to realize that when you ovulate, it doesn't necessarily mean it's the same time every month. And sometimes it's just perhaps when the egg drops. These are the important things they must know, because in some books, it actually says every 22 days or every 28 days this happens. If they read that, they're gonna literally take that as that's what's gonna happen. And as all of us know, that's not always the case, especially when it comes to a body, and especially a woman's body. So those are the things you have to specifically talk about with them, that even though it's usually around 22 days or whatever the case may be, it's not always on the 22nd day. The other thing I wanted to mention about menstruation is actually talking to young ladies about this. I would suggest that you start at least 6-7 months previously from what you think he's going to start. And as most women know, there are signs that we know when a young lady is going to start, especially when they start developing their breasts. But also there's sometimes an odor that starts coming around. That is your cue to start having a conversation with them. Make sure they understand that there might be cramping and why there's cramping. Don't just say because it's a woman thing. Make sure they understand it's because their uterus is shedding and it's kind of like twisting and turning, and that's why you're actually cramping. And that there's things that they can do, whether it's hot water, if it's taking a Tylenol, you get the idea. But make sure that they understand there's things that they can do to help. The other thing you need to also be very honest and blunt with young ladies is actually showing them that there's different types of tampons and pads. Most of them will start with pads and are feminine products, and I have an actual helpful hint for you. Ask all your lady friends to donate one or two pads to you. And the reason I say that is we all like something different, and we don't know what your daughter is gonna like. So if you get a variety of different pads, have them try them out. It doesn't mean they just have them wear it for a day. See if which one they like the best. And of course they're not having their menstruation, but it will also help with their sensory issues. It will help them understand and feel that there's gonna be something different in between their legs, but that's important to remember. The other thing you might wanna tell them and show them is that actually when their menstruation starts, there are different colors of different stages of menstruation. Make sure that they understand if it's a little brown, it's okay. If it's red, it's okay. So sometimes parents have actually used different food colorings to show them that sometimes when they go to the bathroom, there's gonna be different colors. Keep these things in mind, be honest, be blunt, and you can always check out different books. There's plenty of them out there. This is Bridget with Life on Spectrum. Thanks for watching that episode, and make sure you come back and join us again for upcoming videos. They'll be uploaded almost on a daily basis. Also, if you really enjoyed us, like us below, or even leave a comment for us to respond back to. And if for all of you that are really involved in the Life on Spectrum, make sure you subscribe to our YouTube channel. We appreciate you, we hope that this is worthwhile for you, and we'll see you next time on Life on Spectrum.